Hello friends, once again welcome to Diksha classroom. In the last video we have discussed various international efforts that finally culminated in Rio Summit. In this video we are going to discuss Rio Summit, which is also known as Earth Summit, one of the most important effort in the field of environment preservation so far. Rio Summit happened in 1992 June. It was the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development, or UNCED, that took place in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Since it happened in Rio de Janeiro, it's also known as Rio Summit, it's also known as Earth Summit. It was happened in the year 1992, very important. There were a lot of important outcomes for Rio Summit. One of the most important outcome was Agenda 21. Agenda 21 is a not legally binding document adopted during the Rio Summit. This Agenda 21 discusses about various agendas for the 21st century that has to be followed or that has to be taken consideration by all the countries across the world for any future environment preservation. Remember, Agenda 21 deals with various recommendations that every country has to be followed in future. So we are discussing different outcomes of Rio Summit. First one was Agenda 21. Then after Agenda 21, we have the Rio Declaration, or Rio Declaration on Environment and Development. Okay, it is also about a document. Rio Declaration is also a document focusing on future sustainable development. So two documents were an outcome of Rio Summit, Rio Declaration and Agenda 21. And most important outcome of Rio Summit was Rio Convention. After Rio Declaration and Agenda 21, Rio Convention were the significant outcome of Rio Summit. Basically, three conventions were adopted or formed in Rio Summit. First convention was Convention for Biological Diversity, next convention for Climate Change Mitigation, next convention to combat desertification. So convention related to these three topics were adopted in Rio Summit. Those three conventions are Convention on Biological Diversity to deal with biodiversity. I hope you will be clear it from the name itself, Convention on Biological Diversity. Then you have the much discussed UN Framework Convention on Climate Change, or UNFCC, to deal with climate change. Then you have UN Convention to Combat Desertification, UNCCD, to deal with desertification. So there are three conventions as a part of Rio Summit: Biodiversity Protection Convention, known as CBD, or Convention on Biological Diversity, Convention to deal with climate change mitigation, that is UNFCC. Very important, previously asked, expansion of UNFCCC, that is UN Framework Convention on Climate Change. Then next convention was to reduce the rate of desert formation or desertification. Convention is known as UNCCD, UN Convention to Combat Desertification. In the syllabus, they have specifically stated Convention on Biological Diversity and UNFCC. So we'll be going to all the convention one by one. First convention, Convention on Biological Diversity, also known as CBD. As we have discussed already, this convention was opened as a part of Rio Summit 1992. The signing by different countries started in the Rio Summit itself, and it came into force in 29 December 1993. And the importance of Convention on Biological Diversity is that many of the provisions of CBD is legally binding. So most of the provisions of CBD is legally binding. There are basically three objectives. Remember, three objectives as a part of CBD. They were conservation of biological diversity, a general objective, a general agreement. Then sustainable use of components of biological diversity. Then the third one was fair and equitable sharing of benefits arising from the genetic resources. So basically, there are three goals: conservation of biological diversity, sustainable use of components of biological diversity, then fair and equitable sharing of benefits arising from genetic resources. So first one is a general idea, second one is more specific. We'll be discussing in details regarding the second and third point. So the secretariat or the headquarters of Convention on Biological Diversity is Montreal in Canada, very important. And the Conference of Parties, I hope you know Conference of Parties, which we have discussed in the first video as a meeting of the parties of convention. So Conference of Parties is a governing body of Convention on Biological Diversity, and it include all the parties who have ratified. They have to sign as well as to ratify. And this COP meets every 2 years. We have given details regarding US has signed but not ratified, so it's not a party, okay? But it has a chance to attend the meetings of CBD, even though it's not a party. The COP or the Conference of Parties of CBD meets every 2 years, okay? Every 2 years there will be meeting. The first meeting was in 1994, it was adopted in 1993, it was in Bahamas. Then the COP11 meeting, okay, every 2 years there will be a meeting. We are just stating some of the important meeting. COP11 meeting happened in 2012, it happened in Hyderabad. The only time COP to CPD, Conference of Parties to Convention on Biological Diversity, happened in India was the year 2002, happened in Hyderabad. Then we have COP13 in Cancun, COP14, the last COP happened in Egypt. And the COP15 is supposed to be happened in China in 2020, in this year. It happens towards the end of the year in October. This is the details regarding the locations of various COP to CBD happened. Next, we are moving to the important protocols coming under CBD. We have previously discussed there will be a general convention with a general agreement, and there will be different protocols under different convention with specific legal procedures or strict rules. So there are different protocols under Convention on Biological Diversity also. The first and one of the most important protocols coming under Convention on Biological Diversity is Cartagena Protocol on Biodiversity. Cartagena is a place in Colombia. So Cartagena Protocol on Biodiversity, it was adopted in the year 2000 and it came into force in the year 2003, and the meeting will be in every 2 years along with the meeting of CBD meeting. And we can see or we can look what is the purpose of Cartagena Protocol on Biosafety. Cartagena Protocol aims to ensure the safe handling, transport and use of living modified organisms resulting from modern biotechnology that may have adverse effects on biological diversity, also human health. I hope you know living modified organisms. There will be those organisms, living organisms which have been modified by using biotechnology techniques. So when these living modified organisms are released to the environment, there will be a chance of a lot of environmental risk as well as human risk. So as to solve this issue, CBD adopt Cartagena with the aim to ensure safe handling, transport and usage of living modified organisms. So we discuss protocol deals with living modified organisms, protection of living modified organism. Okay, so as per this protocol, to deal with the safe handling and usage of living modified organism, there have been two concepts: AIA or Advance Informed Agreement and Biosafety Clearinghouse. This Advance Informed Agreement deals with the procedures for ensuring that countries are provided with information necessary to make informed decisions before agreeing to the import. It's very important because the developed countries like America, Canada, etc. develop newly living modified organism and they export it to third world countries or developing countries. So Advance Informed Agreement says that those countries which are exporting it or which have produced it should give necessary information to those countries to which that particular products will be imported. And similarly, this protocol also provides a provision for biosafety clearinghouse. Remember, biosafety clearinghouse. This biosafety clearinghouse helps to facilitate the exchange of information on living modified organism to different countries. So both this advanced informed agreement and biosafety clearinghouse deals with proper utilization, of living modified organisms. And remember, genetically modified organisms and living modified organisms are same in most concept, but there are some differences also. Because living modified organism is any living organism whose genetic material has been altered by biotechnology, which we can say broadly equivalent to genetically modified organism, except normally living modified organisms are capable of growing. At the same time, genetically modified organism can be dead or alive. So this is a general difference, but we even simultaneously use both living modified organism and genetically modified organisms. And when it comes to Cartagena Protocol, there is a group of countries that oppose the provisions of Cartagena Protocol. This group of countries are known as Miami Group. Miami Group opposes the Cartagena provisions. The main countries coming under Miami Group are US, Canada, Australia, Argentina, Chile, Uruguay, etc. The reason why this country is opposed Cartagena is simple. These countries are the major exporters of genetically modified crops, or the countries that rely highly on biotechnology industries. So definitely this protocol have a lot of provision that keeps a set of restriction on them. That's why Miami Group rejects or opposes the Cartagena Protocol. They have the argument that free trade of GM products should be happen across the world. So this is Miami Group that opposes Cartagena Protocol. Next, we have a supplementary protocol on Cartagena. So for the Cartagena Protocol deals with living modified organism, even though it generally deals with living modified organism, all the administrative procedures and requirements so as to make Cartagena Protocol an efficient one was given by Nagoya, Kuala Lumpur supplementary protocol on liability and redress. Remember, this Nagoya, Kuala Lumpur protocol comes under Cartagena Protocol. It's a supplementary protocol to Cartagena with the same purpose of safe handling and usage of living modified organism, but the provisions or the procedures and requirements for the proper functioning of Cartagena Protocol was given by Nagoya, Kuala Lumpur supplementary protocol. Simply, Cartagena deals with protection of living modified organism or safe handling and usage. Detailed provision given by Nagoya, Kuala Lumpur supplementary protocol. Remember, very important, because Nagoya, Kuala Lumpur is a supplementary protocol to Cartagena. At the same time, there is a different protocol known as Nagoya protocol, which doesn't have any relation with living modified organism. So don't get confused with Nagoya and Nagoya, Kuala Lumpur supplementary. So that's all about Cartagena protocol that deal with living modified organisms. Next, we have Nagoya protocol on access benefit share. Next protocol that comes under Convention on Biological Diversity. Nagoya protocol was adopted in COP 10 held at Nagoya in Japan, which happened in the year 2010. The aim of Nagoya protocol is to make equitable sharing of resources coming out of biological diversity, or it deals with access to genetic resources and fair and equitable sharing of benefit arising from their utilization. So this protocol aims at equitable use of benefits of biodiversity. It's mainly done so as to prevent the exploitation of agricultural farmers as well as local people with regards to the utilization of biodiversity in the name of patent. Okay, so a lot of exploitation has been happening across the world in the name of patent. So as to resolve these issues, Convention on Biological Diversity adopted this Nagoya Protocol, which is an international agreement which aims at sharing the benefits arising from the utilization of genetic resources in fair and equitable way, including appropriate access to genetic resources and by appropriate transfer of relevant technologies, taking into account all rights over those resources and to technologies. So this is all about Nagoya Protocol that deals with equitable sharing of genetic resources. So next we have a small aspect, Aichi biodiversity targets. It's also a part of CBD. The COP10 held in Nagoya, which is in Aichi province of Japan, adopted a strategic plan for biodiversity that has to be applicable for the year 2011 to 2020. That has to be applicable for the year 2011 to 2020. Already, there was a strategic plan for the year 2002 to 2010. But from 2010 onwards, this Nagoya meeting revised and updated the existing strategic plan as the new strategic plan for biodiversity for 2011 to 2020, which is in effect as of now. These Aichi biodiversity targets have 20 targets under 5 strategic goals. So Aichi biodiversity has 20 targets under 5 strategic goals. Some are well defined and some are ill defined. Okay, so these are the things we have to discuss under the Rio Summit's Convention on Biological Diversity. We discuss about Rio Summit 3 convention, Convention on Biological Diversity and United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, then United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification. We come to CBD. Within the CBD, we have basically 2 protocols, the Cartagena Protocol dealing with safe handling and usage of living modified organism. Then we have Nagoya Protocol for fair and equitable sharing of genetic resources. And for Cartagena, we discussed about Nagoya Kuala Lumpur supplementary protocols also. So that's all about this video discussing Earth Summit and Convention on Biological Diversity. In the coming video, we'll be discussing about United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Thank you.